Yeah, hi friends, my name is Sudhir Chandan and welcome back to my channel Energy and Environment Education. Friends, this is an important chapter, electric motor, important for all those aspirants who are looking forward to take energy manager exam or energy auditor exam in this year or in coming years, because a lot of questions you can expect from the chapter electric motor. And in this particular video, I'm going to discuss the different formulas that are important for your preparation, exam preparation, and also the numericals which can come in the exam or which are important as far as exam is concerned, friends. So this is an important video for all the energy auditor or energy manager aspirants, and also this is an equally important video for the other engineers, engineers who are preparing for other exams. For them also these formulas, these numericals can be equally important, friends. So please watch the entire video and hopefully this will help you to build some concepts, engineering concepts on electric motors, and also will help you to prepare different type of exam, especially the energy auditor exam or the energy manager exam, friends. So let's start today's video on electric motor. So here are a few important formulas that can come in the exam directly. They may ask you, short answer type questions or numerical based questions, on direct formula based question you can expect in the exam, or also it can be a part of long answer type numerical based question, friends. So these formulas are very much important for you to remember, to learn and keep in mind, friends, when you answer the questions in the exam. So first formula is the synchronous speed, the RPM. They may ask you to calculate the synchronous speed. So formula is 120 into F by number of poles. So F is the frequency and number of poles they will give you, and then you need to calculate the synchronous speed. So directly they may ask you to calculate the synchronous speed, and they will provide you the frequency and number of poles, and in this, using this formula you can calculate the RPM, friends. Similarly, the other formula is important for your understanding and for the exam is concerned is slip percent. I will not explain the slip, what is all about. All these things you can go in the video that I have made on and posted in this channel on the electric motor chapter, friends. So everything is dealt there, everything explained there, what is synchronous speed and what is slip, all this about. But only I am dealing with the formula and the numerical part in this particular video. If you want to have the detailed discussion and entire concept building part of the entire chapter on motor, electric motor, you can go through the video that I have posted. I'll leave the link on the description box after the end of the video, friends. So you can go through the entire video on electric motor and understand the different terminologies and other important aspects of the chapter, friends. For the time being, in this particular video, let's see the different numericals and the formulas that are important. So first formula that I have discussed here is the synchronous speed, RPM, where formula is 120 into F by P, and other formula is the slip percent. In this case, you have to have the synchronous speed minus full load rated speed divided by synchronous speed into 100. This is also an important formula, so they will give you this synchronous speed and full load rated speed, and they will ask you to calculate the slip percent. So unless until you remember this formula, you will not be able to calculate the slip percent, friends. And another formula is the power factor, which is also known as cos phi. So you may be asked to calculate the cos phi. In that case, you may be given the kilowatt and kVA. So just divide the kilowatt by kVA and you get the power factor or the cos phi. It's a very simple formula, but very important formula as per the exam is concerned. So you may be directly asked questions or numericals based on this particular formula, or can be a part of a long answer type question or long answer based numerical questions, friends, where you need to calculate the cos phi or the power factor using kilowatt by kVA. Then another formula which is important as far as exam is concerned or as per the concept is concerned, they will ask you to calculate the efficiency of the motor, and formula is power output by power input, or also you can say 1 minus power loss by power input. So P out is the output of power of the motor, P in is the input power of the motor, and P loss is the losses occurring in the motor. So basically they may ask you to calculate the efficiency of the motor, and you can use these two formulas, either power output by power input, or in terms of losses you can say 1 minus power losses by power input, friends. These two formulas, you can use it while calculating the efficiency of the motor in the exam, friends. Another important formula which may come in the exam directly or indirectly, so they may ask you to calculate the friction and windage and core losses. So So this is the formula for the friction windage and core losses. No load power minus no load current square into stator resistance. This is the entire formula for the calculation of, you know, friction and windage and core losses, friends. So you can use this formula to calculate this particular friction and windage and core losses, friends, in the exam if they ask you to calculate any question directly or a part of the longest type numerical based question, friends. Now another formula which is important is the stator winding resistance. So in that case, R2 by R1 equals to 235 minus T2, 235 plus T2 will be the formula for calculating the stator winding resistance, friends. Where T1 is the ambient temperature and T2 is the operating temperature, and both the temperatures are given in degree centigrade, friends. So this can be an important formula also to calculate the stator winding resistance. Now for the calculation of rotor or I square losses, you can say slip into stator input minus stator I square losses minus core loss. This is also an important formula, and you must mug up and this you should understand also and remember this formula, friends, if they ask you to calculate the rotor I square R losses. So formula is slip multiplied by stator input minus stator I square losses minus core loss, friends. It's a very important formula as far as the exam is concerned, where they may ask you different type of questions, you mean basically numerical based questions from this particular formula, friends. Now let's try to understand one numerical which is very much important as far as exam is concerned. This numerical has been asked number of times earlier also, and you may expect in the coming exam also. Basically this is a full complete one long answer type numerical based question, friends, and you may expect to have a full question or maybe divided into, you know, sub parts, or only some part of or small part of this entire question can be asked in the exam as a short type or numerical based question, friends. So you may expect in both the ways this type of numerical. So let's see the numerical which is very much important for the examination point of view. Here the motor specification given, basically rated power is given as 34 kilowatt or 45 HP you can consider. Voltage is given, current is given, speed is given, insulation class is given, frame connection delta. So this is the motor specification which is already given to you for your understanding. Then no load test data is also given here, but the voltage given, current is given, frequency is given, stator phase resistance at 30 degree centigrade is given, and no load power data is given here. So you need to use all this data while calculating different questions that I'm going to show you in coming slides, friends, which is very much important for the examination concerned. Now as per the last slide that you saw, different data is provided to you. On the basis of those data, they will ask you to calculate these different questions, or you can say numericals, friends, in the exam. Either they will ask you to calculate the entire set of the questions, or they may ask you only a part of it to calculate only a single question from the entire data, friends. So from this data you need to calculate the iron plus friction and windage losses. This is the first question. Secondly is to calculate stator resistance at 120 degree centigrade. Third is to calculate stator copper losses at operating temperature of 120 degree centigrade. Calculate full load slip and rotor input assuming rotor losses. Determine the motor input assuming stray losses are 0.5% of the motor rated power. And calculate motor full load efficiency and full load power factor, friends. So these are different questions which are very much important for your concept building also, for your understanding, friends. And as far as exam is concerned, number of times this type of questions have come as a whole or a part of it, friends, in the exam. So please be prepared for this particular, you know, question. It's a very important question, and different type of numericals, you can say formulas are applied in this particular question, friends. So we'll discuss the different formulas that are applied and how this question is solved in the exam, friends. So basically in this particular solution, you can see here the entire question is solved part by part. So if you see the first part here, the, you know, iron plus friction and windage loss is calculated, that is PI by F plus FW, that is calculated here. But prior to that calculation, you need to calculate the stator copper losses. So that is the formula is 3 into, you can say, the current divided by root 3 square into, you know, the stator phase resistance at 30 degree centigrade. So you can see the data is taken from here, the same data that I have showed you in the last slide, where the different data is presented here. So you can see this 3 into 16.1 is taken from here, that is the current or ampere. 0.264 is taken from here at the stator phase resistance. So basically when you calculate stator copper loss, you need to multiply the 3 into, you know, current by root 3 square, and also multiply by the, you know, stator phase resistance at 30 degree centigrade, because you need to calculate at the 30 degree centigrade. So when you calculate all this, you multiply all this, you get the answer 68.43 watts. So this is the stator copper loss, friends. Now when ultimately you are going to calculate the iron plus friction and windage loss, that is PI plus FW. for that you need to calculate the the no load power minus stator copper loss. That is the thing that you have to calculate. So again, you can see here this no load power stator. You have to take from here the data already provided to you, and you have to subtract it with the 68.43 that you have already calculated. That is the stator copper loss. So that's why you need to calculate the stator copper loss, friends. Otherwise, they are asking you to calculate PI plus FW. But to calculate PI plus FW, you have to have two things. One is the no load power, and second thing is the stator copper loss. So no load power already given to you, and stator copper loss you need to calculate it. And for calculating stator copper loss, formula will be, this is the applying formula. You have applied it, and then you have calculated the stator copper loss, friends. So by this, you can subtract the stator copper loss from the no load power, and you get the PI plus FW, which is nothing but the iron plus friction and windage losses, friends. So this is the first part of the numerical, friends. Now coming to the second part, where the stator resistance at 120 degrees centigrade has to be calculated. For this, this is a formula already have shown to you in the other slides, earlier slides, where this is the formula is important for you to understand, to learn. And this particular formula is applied here to calculate the stator resistance at 120 degrees centigrade. So the formula you have applied, and the value is 0.354 ohms per phase. So this is the now result of the stator resistance at 120 degrees centigrade, applying this particular formula, friends. So second part is also solved. Now coming to third part, where the stator copper loss at full load is to be calculated. Now see here, you have already calculated the stator copper loss at 30 degrees centigrade. Now they are asking to calculate at full load at 120 degrees centigrade. Now formula remains the same as you have done here. Same will be here also. Here you have multiplied by 3 into 16.1 by root 3 square. Here it is 3 into 57 by root 3 square. Here it is 0.264, and here it is 0.354. For both the questions, you are calculating the stator copper loss. It is at 30 degrees centigrade, and it is at the 120 degrees centigrade. So for this, formula remains the same. Now you have applied 3 into 57 by root 3 square. Now why you have taken 57, not 16.1? 16.1 was for the no load, and 57 is for the, you can see here, the motor specification. So you have taken data from here, the motor specification where the full load is shown here. So this current is coming from here, and formula is 3 into 57 by root 3 under square into 0.354. now 354 is coming from, you can see here, 0.354 is coming from here. This is the stator resistance at the 120 degrees centigrade. So in this case, here the stator resistance was at the 30 degrees centigrade, which is coming from here, and here the stator resistance you have calculated earlier, and you are putting it here, friends. So for this question and this question, formula remains same. Only degree centigrade is 30 degrees centigrade. For that, you have taken data from here, and for 120, you have calculated this part and put it here, friends. So 3 into 57 by root 3 square, and into multiplied by 0.354, which is nothing but the stator resistance, friends, which we have already calculated in the B part, friends. Now coming to the D part of the question, friends, you need to calculate the full load slip. Formula is very simple. Already you can see slip percent formula is there, synchronous speed minus full load rated speed by synchronous speed into 100. This particular formula is applied here. Instead of simple slip percent, they are calculating slip. Same thing, synchronous speed minus full load rated speed by synchronous speed will be the formula for the calculation of the full load slip, friends. So instead of slip percent, you are only calculating slip here. So you will not be calculating the percentage here, only slip part will be calculated here using the same formula. So this is again added, I mean calculated here, and you see here the full load rated speed is given here already in the question. That is already in the other slides I have showed you also as a reference. I put it here. So 1475 is coming from here. You just subtract it and you get the answer, friends. So rotor input also has to be calculated. For that, power output by 1 minus slip is the formula. So you just you put the all the different data or parameters here, and you calculate the rotor input power, friends. So power output already given here, that is 34 kilowatt. So you have calculated in the converted into watt, 34,000 watt, and 1 minus s is already slip already calculated here. So put the formula, the data here, and calculate the rotor input. So it is 34577.4 watts, friends. Now coming to the E part, motor full load input power. So in this case, you have to add all these: rotor input, stator copper loss, iron plus friction and windage losses, and stray losses. So if you add all these, you get the motor full load input power, friends. PR you have already calculated here. PSTCU, that is copper losses already calculated here. Pi plus Fw already calculated in the earlier slide, and P stray already it is given here, that is 0.5% of the rated output, which is 34,000. So 0.5% of rated output is, you can calculate it here and put it here, friends. So when you add all these, you get the answer 36892.8 watts, friends. So this is the thick part of the numerical which can be calculated. So you can see here all these parts are interlinked to each other, and you, once you calculate first part, you get the second part and third part you can calculate, fourth part is used here to calculate the fifth part, friends. So in this way you can calculate all the five parts of the question, friends. Now coming to the sixth part of the numerical, that is efficiency calculation. So formula already you know, I have given you in the first slide itself, the power output by power input into 100 is the formula for calculating the efficiency of the motor. That same formula is applied here, and power output already have you know that is 34 kilowatt it is, so convert into 34,000 watt. And power input you have calculated in the last slide, I have showed you, this is the figure, you multiply divide by power output by power input into 100 and you calculate the efficiency of the motor, friends. Same way for the power factor, you know the formula root 3 pi cos phi is the formula for the power input. So in this case you need to calculate the power factor, so power input divided by root 3 V and I, where V is the voltage, I is the current, friends. And you just need to divide power input by root 3 VI and you get the power factor, friends. So this is the formula applied here to calculate the power factor, and this is the end of the numerical, friends. So with this I am ending the part A of this chapter. Basically, friends, I have discussed all the important formulas and numericals. Also I'll continue with the part B, where also I'll be dealing with the other important formulas and numericals which can come in the exam, which is important for you to understand and also to learn and also to remember it, friends, as far as the exam is concerned. And all for engineering students also, these formulas and these numericals can help them to build their concept for other exams also concerned, friends. So end of part A, and we'll continue with the part B in the coming video, friends. So with this I'm ending today's video, friends. Please do subscribe my channel Energy and Movement Education, which is present in YouTube. You can go through different chapters that I have posted on this channel, friends, which will help you to not only prepare for energy auditor or major exam, also for other engineering exams, friends. So you can go through different chapters that I have posted on this channel. This is my mobile number and my email ID, which can, any query if you have, you can write me down with your queries, your thoughts or inputs on my email ID or also my WhatsApp number 8800671509. This is my channel, friend. Please do subscribe. This will motivate me to prepare more such videos in coming days. And I'm also going to prepare lot many videos on different numericals based on different chapters from the Bureau of Energy Efficiency exam, which may help you out for your exam preparation, friends. Also, please press the bell icon such that you get the instant notification as soon as I post a new video in coming days, friends. So please be connected with me. Please do subscribe my channel. Please press the bell icon. Please write me any inputs if you have, any thoughts if you have on my channel content. And also please go through the different videos that I have made, not only on the numerical based questions, also on different chapters that I made and posted on my channel, friends. So you can go through the videos, and this video will really help you out in preparation of your exam, friends. So that's all for today. Let's meet in a new video in coming days, friends.